Welcome back to my YouTube channel. We're doing an Instagram followers control my day. So let's start with the outfit. So I put on my poll for you guys to choose. First of all, I'm really bad at outfits. I mean, actually, you know, I fuck with this. This is like from Amazon. But maybe you guys can help me with the outfits throughout this whole process. But we're either going super neutral, well, neutral and blacks, or we're going black and a little bit of ColourPop. So I'm gonna put it on, see what you guys say, and then we're headed to a breakfast meeting. So this is what we're gonna wear for breakfast, and then you guys will pick the rest of my day.
All right, so the answer was neutrals and black. Bottoms are Lululines, top is Paragon. This from Amazon, and these are New Balances. So let's go to breakfast. I actually really fuck with this fit. Now to complete the outfit, are we gonna go with, Dylan actually got this for me.
Shout out. Literally are only two purses.
I know, the only two options. There's only two options. Okay,
what did we? Even purse.
Wait, what did I have for a long time? That's why you got me one.
Oh my gosh, she had one that she had from like freshman year of college for like 7 years, and it was just ripped and like it was like the amount of like whatever like these that there were, it was like frayed, like six of them. So it looked like she had six different like loops.
So he, you know, decided it was not gonna happen like that anymore. So he got me this black one.
So I got her this 2 years ago.
2 years ago.
2 years ago on your birthday, because your birthday is in like 3 weeks, and she still has not purchased her own purse. And then she got
it's
this
a fucking staple. Yeah, I actually really love this because I hate wearing something around my, like over my shoulder. So this has been great to just like.
Maybe you're in order for a purse this year. We'll see.
Maybe, but anyway, so we're gonna see what you guys pick.
You guys picked the black purse. We have it. We're in the fit. We're at breakfast with Bianca. Who's our yoga instructor, let's go with you. So stay tuned for weekly videos. We're talking all the things, meetups, sound bowls. Oh my gosh, what else? I'm missing things, what else?
Pilates.
Pilates, all the stuff. So if you guys have any feedback on what you'd like to see in the yoga section, let us know. We're going over to breakfast. You're gonna choose it for me. Hopefully you guys pick something good.
All right, so the Instagram poll went live. You guys picked steak and eggs. It's looking good. And a fresh juice. I'm actually surprised because I put an iced coffee. You guys didn't pick it, so hopefully it's good. It's my first time coming here. They didn't have many dairy-free options. This was all I had, basically, or besides an omelet. And the avocado toast was just avocado and bread, so this is a great choice.
All right, so we just got back from lunch. Now we got a lot of work to do, so I'm gonna have you guys choose. I normally do it at home. But, you know, I'm gonna spice it up today, make it a little spicy. We're gonna do the library or bookstore or a coffee shop. So we'll see what you say. And the next thing I wanna, in case I need to book a class, I'm gonna have you guys choose between a leg day, which I'm kind of hoping for because I'm feeling for it, or a fitness class. So I'm gonna ask you guys right now, but I'm gonna get a little, you know, I need a little, do a little dancey dance. We're gonna play a song and we're gonna ask y'all, see what you think. Behind the scenes of me embarrassing myself and my story. Let's see what they say. All right. All right, so you guys pick the next place I'm going to work, which is a coffee shop, which I actually haven't done in a long time. I've been working quiet from the freaking back. Anyway, we're gonna go to a coffee shop. So let's see which one I'm gonna go to. And then I'm gonna do some work there. And then you guys have my full day. You guys are picking out my workout. You guys are picking out my date tonight, which I'm super excited about. We're about to decide on my car, which I'm a little nervous about. If you've been following me on YouTube, did you seriously just play applause button? Anyway, I asked this question like in my first YouTube video, if I should wrap my car, and I'm about to ask you guys if I'm gonna do it. If you guys say yes, then I'm gonna make the call. I know, holy fuck. But the orange is so iconic. I'm a little nervous, but anyway, let's do it.
There is my beautiful little car. So we're gonna see. And I still have the damn stickers on for my Scooby-Doo challenge. But I've been rocking with it, I fuck with it. Dylan is not into it, but I think she's a little cutie pie. Anyway, do we go full purple? We're about to find out. I can't believe it. Can we just talk?
So we just got back from the coffee shop, and normally I work at home because I have my lemonade, my snacks, my food, my kitties, and my man in case I want a little, you know, something midday. But it was a great, you know, change of scenery. My focus was just insane. So I'm excited to push myself out of my comfort zone, which is my theme for August. Because I don't know about you guys, but it hit me yesterday where I was saying to myself, I have a year until I'm getting married. And I don't even know how to roast a damn turkey in the oven. You know, my whole life I grew up, me and my sister made meals growing up because my parents worked full time. And it was always really simple, easy meals. Like, we did spaghetti. My sister and I were dying laughing because we were laughing. We were talking about all the meals we had as kids that, you know, fed our inner child, and every single one of them had spaghetti in it. But I have not dove into, you know, the more intensive side of cooking and making more extravagant dishes where we're at home and we don't really have any guests ever, but if they have a guest, I want a damn dinner party, and I want to make a charcuterie board that blows your fucking mind away. So I want to just dive into more aspects of myself, and I feel like, you know, we are trying to focus really on our relationship with ourselves. We're trying to hit the gym. We're trying to fucking shave our cucinis. We're trying to figure out how to do my hair and makeup, which I still don't know how to do. We're trying to develop relationship with other people and our family and excel in work and businesses. And it's fucking like, it's just too much. It's so hard to balance everything. So my biggest thing, without getting overwhelmed and feeling guilty, is just recognizing what is calling me in that moment, what the universe is fucking telling me. And right now, it's my era. Like, it is my fucking era right now. It is telling me, okay, this may not be the time for you to, you know, try to go out and make new friendships right now, because life is so crazy busy and I'm number one always. And right now I have this like deep sense to just do crazy shit outside my comfort zone, because I have a list. Like, I have this list with things I want to do, places I want to eat, things I want to experience, and nothing's been checked off. I don't know if you guys have the same thing, but nothing's been checked off because life is crazy. And my biggest goal coming into August is to do stuff outside my comfort zone, but also start checking off that damn list. Like, start checking it the fuck off, because I want to develop such a deep relationship with myself. That's my biggest goal. And the most amazing moments, most amazing things in my life have come out of just making off the wall decisions, ones that I was terrified to make, move to Colorado. Even little things, like I tried out for a dance club at Virginia Tech with no dance experience. I've never taken a dance class. I did not make it, but it was so much fun, and it pushed me to, I did a dance routine with for Sculpt You October video. That was like one of the best things of my life. Like, it was so much fun. So I want to connect to more of those things and see what fuels me, and connect more to like, what did myself as a child like to do, and how can I bring that into my adult life, and how can I start, you know, really getting to know who I am, because it's hard to check off that list. So two things that I'm doing is aligning with who I want to become, and then second, which is our non-negotiables, our core values, and just that person that you want to be, and aligning with, what are they saying? What are they doing? How are they acting? And reflecting on, are you doing those things? And it's a good practice, even when you're in the mirror talking to yourself, to sit there and be like, oh shit, that's not what she would say, bitch. That's not what she would say. Or, you know, that's not something she would do, or she would do that. Fucking do it. So that's the next one thing. And the next thing is, we all have crazy busy schedules. So how can you incorporate those things into your routine? Because we're not gonna do it if it's not on my Google Calendar. But so it's scheduling those date nights. It's saying, hey, I'm gonna take 10 minutes tonight and maybe 10 minutes of your time here and there and research some trips I'd wanna go on. And so you actually book it. Or it's just, I wanna go to that coffee shop like I did today, a new coffee shop. And I've been thinking about going, but I'm gonna do the damn thing. So for me, I have to have the mixture, because life gets crazy and you get into your rut. So it's putting the two together. All right, so the poll's in. We're gonna make a Big Mac bowl in this bitch. So super easy. Ground beef, we're gonna cook it real quick. I'm gonna cut up an onion, tomato, pickles, lettuce, and then we're gonna make a little Big Mac sauce. You're supposed to combine mayo, mustard, ketchup, a little bit of vinegar, but I'm just gonna do garlic aioli mayo, the best thing ever, Primal Kitchen. A little ketchup and a little vinegar. That's gonna be my Big Mac sauce. Super easy. Let's get started. Hi, my name's Katrina Wright. I was interested in getting my car wrapped, like a lavender color. I was just curious if you guys do that.
Oh yeah, we can totally do that.
I got all these veggies from the farmer's market on Sunday. I've been going every single Sunday as one of, because it starts at 8, so it's great to just start your day that way. I go really quick, I go before the crowd goes, and I just get my veggies for the week, and I've been loving getting soaps and stuff. That's been a great self-date that I know I'm plugging in. It's like becoming a part of my routine every single week, so I love it.
All right, so now we have the Big Mac bowl. I actually have so many veggies, I couldn't fit it in this bowl. So I'm gonna have to do two bowls, but that's that. And also look what we got today. Sculpt You packaging, can you see it? It says Sculpt You, and then it will say, no one is you and that is your power. And it shows up from the inside, the clothing be on the inside, if that makes sense. Super cute. So we have two options for the gym. We got the colors or the neutrals, just a classic gray and black, or we got, you know, rainbow bright and a blue top. So let's see what you pick. Not me carrying the whole tripod camera on the tripod. Listen, I don't wanna take it off, but we got this colorful outfit going on. So I got this from TikTok. I honestly don't remember when or how, but I just remember seeing them on an ad. And I was like, these look fun. They're kind of like the Amazon, exactly like the Amazon leggings, probably the same exact ones. This is also from Amazon, the top, but it's colorful, all right. Like, we are going in the back.
Mm. All right, so I'm having you guys pick my entire leg day. So I'm giving you guys a structure, how I typically structure my group focus leg days. But I'm gonna give you some exercises you can choose from. So we typically like to start off our glute focus leg day with putting our glutes in the most shortened position, and it's gonna fatigue our glute max. So typically like a thrust, bridge variation on our glute focus leg days. So I gave you guys a past glute bridge, or basically a hip thrust pulse, you could call that. A hip thrust or a single leg dumbbell hip thrust. I've been fucking with them lately, I've been loving them. All right, so it looks like we're starting off with a barbell hip thrust. And again, when it comes to a short movement, that just means it's hardest in the most contracted or shortest position of the movement. So in a hip thrust, at the top of the movement where your ass is the most contracted, that is the most source of tension, the hardest portion of the movement, so that is our shortened position. So we're gonna fatigue out that glute max, and then we're gonna go into a lay-in position. Let's go. Music.
She got that good, good. She Michael Jackson bad. I'm attracted to her for her attractive ass. And now we murderers because we kill time. I knock her lights out and she still shine.
Luce is legitimately asleep during my fucking workout. But we still gotta keep the energy going. So the next movement is working the glutes in the lengthen position, aka peak tension and the lengthening of the muscle. So we're gonna give you the choice of barbell RDL, dumbbell RDLs, or an RDL into a split squat. Looks like you guys are choosing barbell RDLs, which I really was hoping for dumbbell, but what do you think? The energy has gotta fucking give. Let's check the results. It's been enough time. It's barbell RDLs, god damn it.
But I keep on running back and forth like a soccer team. Cold as a winter day, hot as a summer's eve.
All right, so the next movement is a movement in the mid-range position. I put split squats on my story, but it honestly looks like you guys are gonna choose it, and I'm gonna say RIP at this moment, honestly. It's over for me. It's really winning. If you guys really said, fuck you, fuck you to this.
I like the way you walk, and if you walk in my way, I'm that Red Bull.
So our next movement is a glute kickback. It was between, we were doing an accessory movement to end the lift. It was between a back extension and a glute kickback. So I'm gonna do a glute medius kickback, which basically means we're gonna approach the cable. So I use just a little attachment. So what you're gonna do, this is much farther away than you'd normally be. You'd normally be a lot closer, so you can have more stability here. But what you're gonna do for a glute medius kickback, we're gonna lean slightly forward, we're gonna angle this out at a 45 degree angle. You wanna make sure your non-working leg is not too bent, that it's slightly bent, and you wanna have as much stability as possible, so we're gonna go here. And you're not gonna, I'm gonna take this out to show you, you're not gonna kick back like this. We're going to pretend that we're just, like, legitimately flex your glute and pull it up. You can even feel without the cable. So let's get into it.
Let's buy a place with all kind of space. I let you be the judge, and I'm the case. I'm gutter, gutter. I put her under. I see me with her. No Stevie Wonder. She don't even wonder.
All right. I think this is how I talk into the mirror. My legs hurt. That was a fiery leg day. Thank you guys. Shout out. That's how I typically structure my leg days, from a shorter position to lengthen mid-range to accessory movements. So if you wanted to sculpt your leg day picture, that was it. But now it's 8:40, so I could make dinner or I could order dinner. I'm gonna let you guys decide. So as I was looking in the mirror while I was waiting for, I was about to talk to you guys, one of the biggest shifts I made recently, and you gotta try this. So I looked in the mirror today and I said, okay, regardless, well, this is not a good day because I had you guys pick what to do for me, but look in the mirror and say, is my body truly enjoying the movement I'm giving it? Is my body truly enjoying the food I'm giving it? Because often we go based off of, kind of this challenges, but in general, we go based off of what we think we need to do because we want to look a certain way, we think we need to do because we want to please other people, whatever the case it is. So I want you to ask yourself, are you aligned with what truly actually feels good? Block the noise out and ask yourself, are you aligned with what makes you feel good? And tune into your body, because we rarely sit there and ask our bodies how it feels after we eat or train or do anything, so ask yourself. Anyway, all right. Let's see what I'm really hungry too, so.
All right, so you guys picked sushi. So I got it, picked it up, ordered everything you wanted. I came in my little tracksuit. The waitress in there said she's gonna order a tracksuit now. And there's my boo thing. He stopped his whole workout because he didn't want me to go downtown. Disregard the fact that my lights are out, but anyway. And he just stopped his whole workout because he didn't want me to go downtown by myself. All right, we secured the bag. So salmon roll, ceviche, a little bit more salmon. I'm hungry. And then we'll have some dessert.
All right, so we're finishing up the night with our sushi. What is it? It is 10 o'clock. So we're gonna eat dinner. And then I gave you guys the option of reading a book, play The Sims, and down The Sims, which I haven't done in so long. And it is one of my favorite games of all time. That is feeding my inner child, and then or watching Jersey Shore. All great options. Let's see what you guys picked for what I'm going to do this evening. All right. Watching Jersey Shore is the winner. Hell yeah. So I'm gonna be like a little meatball on my couch and watch Jersey Shore with my sushi. And I planned on taking myself out on a date, but it just got way too late. We had a lot of things to do. So this was a great little date night I had for myself. And that's the thing, wellness and take yourself on a date and self-love doesn't have to be so extravagant. I was just talking with our registered dietitian about this, because when it comes to wellness, we feel like we have to buy all these expensive supplements and do all these, have this crazy routine, and it seems so unattainable, and that's just not the case. Wellness to you is little habits that you can bring into your routine that makes you feel good and empowered. So don't fall to the bullshit. And same when it comes to self-love dates. Oh! You know what I'm saying? You don't have to do anything super extravagant. It's just some time where you can quiet down. And typically I like to do it without, you know, distracting myself. But times you can quiet down, just spend with yourself and start to enjoy your own company and laugh with yourself and have fun with yourself. So hope you guys take yourself on a date soon and show yourself some love. And cheers. Also, this is water.
All right, we're playing the Jersey Shore. Now we have two options for dessert. You guys are heading for the chocolate, which you guys know me way too freaking well. So, hell yeah. I'm gutter, gutter. I put up.